Buenas tardes! Ici es la muy mágica habitación del Palacio de Romain Bro. Yes, yes, yes. Welcome to Open the Gate. Today and tonight it will be with Charlie Lebindu.
Hi.
Hey Charlie, thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you.
You brought your magic table full of surprise tonight.
Yes.
I'm very excited to make it happen. But first, I would like to talk a little bit about you.
Okay.
So, from Bordeaux
right.
to Berlin to London to Paris. We're
going
to make it very quick because I need to understand this little trip. You left your city to experiment in Berlin?
Yeah, I was in Bordeaux until 17 mm-hmm. in a punk air salon. And then I moved to Berlin to basically just to do haircuts in clubs because when I moved there, I had no money. So I took a chair and scissors and a mirror and I was doing haircuts in clubs.
You took the money from the drag queens?
From the drags and also from just people dancing because I wanted them to be my clients, nightlife people, because Berlin is very boring during the day.
So that's why you moved to London?
That's why I moved to London.
Because London is not boring during the day.
But during the night it is.
Uh-oh.
And then, and then I moved to London to start my shows, my week shows, and that's it really.
Me, I discovered you when you were living in London and you were doing those crazy fashion shows during mm-hmm. the fashion week in London. And you had like those crazy outfit full of blood, amazing wigs with the fashion twist also mm-hmm. inside. How did you combine like hair and fashion being just a hairdresser?
I think it was just really easy. I just, there is this thing from the 90s called haute coiffure. Mm. And it's like haute couture but for
like
hairdresser.
Haute couture, okay.
Exactly. So I just wanted to put this on the new level, basically.
Okay, but you were so young. We're talking about like you were 23, 24, no?
23 when I did my first show. Yeah.
It was just like a year ago, because now you're 24, right?
Exactly.
Anyway, I'm a bit bored, so I'm going to make something happened. Oh! So
beautiful.
You came with some, lovely. Beautiful, let me see. Oh, she's really pretty, isn't she? Of course, it's natural hair.
Of course.
You've been working on her for hours.
Russian hair.
Russian hair, amazing. Yeah, thanks, bye. And that was very pretty, Charlie.
Thank you.
You do a lot of things like that?
Yes.
Oh, sorry. Oh, this one looks really amazing. And. Very interesting, I must say.
Go back down, please.
Oh no, yeah, maybe we call you later. Thank you so much. Yeah, let's skip the wig for the moment. So I just want to try to understand you, young boy, a bit crazy, full of tattoo, mm-hmm. crazy style, a bit like rebel, I must say. You broke my baguette, not a bread one, of course. And so, like in London, you've been like piercing this fashion and mm-hmm. crazy art world. I mean, we saw your work on Lady Gaga. I mean, let's talk mm-hmm. about her a bit. And of course, Lana Del Rey also.
Yeah.
In France, we saw you working with Mylène Farmer. Mm-hmm. I know that you're connected with Crazy Horse for some special wigs project. You work with like the most glamorous and sexy ladies.
Mm-hmm.
How did you touch this area? I mean, it's a very closed and not easy world.
I don't
world.
Really touch them usually. But
yeah? Tell us all about it.
But no, I think it's just something that I love. More like cabaret and performance
mm-hmm.
and artists. I'm more into this. Even for my shows, that's what I use. I don't like to use models. Unless it's black model, I will never use a white model.
Ah, yeah.
So that's why I just have dancers or performers in my shows.
Okay. So Charlie, this is all super interesting. I have just like a little question for you. You're very young and you're an artist and you're working with a lot of codes. You're a bit like the bridge between John Waters and Tim Burton. You're like extremely eccentric. Mm-hmm. You've got your tattoo twist, your idea and identity. I mean, this is very interesting, but how come a young guy like you is like mixing all those very retro touches mm-hmm. into this like 2014 coming?
I mean, people like John Waters and I mean, all the gay industry, I've always been very inspired by it. But I just, I'm more inspired by the gypsy industry, I would say.
Interesting.
Yeah. Then, I don't know, for all my stuff, I never really think about things when I do a collection or I create something or a project. I don't really think about it. I just make what I want to do. I have so many ideas. I eat lots of cheese at night, you know, and then I have so many crazy dreams that I want to realize.
Talking about dreams, let's make some magic here.
Oh!
That's your new style, Charlie?
She's beautiful.
Yeah, I think she's missing something. We asked you to put a wig on! Remember? A wig on! So Sorry about that. Some technical problem, I guess. So London was a success, and being like part of the Fashion Week during Paris gave you a bit of a pre-taste for this fashion world in Paris. And then you came and moved into the Parisian world. How come?
I just wanted to change, you know. As I say, my parents are gypsies, so I like to move around.
Mm-hmm. We saw that.
And then I don't want to... I don't know, I don't think I will stay here forever anyway.
Yeah.
But it's easier for me to work here and have my shows here.
Don't you think Paris is very inspiring? I mean, you've got all the cabaret since you love it and all the gypsies mm-hmm. that you would like to meet and work
yeah.
with. Don't you are scared to move again?
Not at all. I just want to go to Mexico or LA or somewhere where there is sun, basically.
Okay. Mm. Let's get some work to do. Ah, here we go with the yellow horrible. Oh, it's really a disaster. I'm sorry, Charlie. I'm a bit disappointed about this one.
It
doesn't work. I mean, what is this? It's full of notes, and maybe you could save her with her.
No, sorry, I don't like dreadlocks.
Oh, okay. Then I'm sorry. We ask you to. Yeah. Thank you. Charlie, is there any project that you are proud and very excited to share with us?
I mean, I like all the projects I did from the monument, but I think I will never be happy until I don't cover the Eiffel Tower from air.
With hair?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Is hair your only media that you want to talk with?
Yeah, it's my only big dream. And when I will realize this, I will stop.
Okay.
So I don't think I will stop ever.
Very good. Fair enough. Let's get some more hair on this table. Ah, so the color is pink. She just arrived from Nice. Oh, that's very beautiful. What was the inspiration for this wig, Charlie?
It's called cardboard.
Cupboard.
And wallpaper paint.
Ah, glue. Lovely. So wallpaper glue, can we use that on our natural hair?
Yes, you can.
Yeah, it's a bit like
Of course, it's a bit spray. Like gel.
Gel. The new gel. It's beautiful, lovely. Thank you, we'll call you back. Lovely. Do you have other tricks to make hair stay like this? Lovely, we stay, oh God. Do you have like other tricks to make the magic happen on hair?
I think not really. I always say on girls, for a really bad hair day, the best is just to go even worse, because it's never going to be a good day anyway.
That's what happens in
like
London.
Like your hair. You had a bad hair day today.
No,
so
my hair
just
is
went worse.
Fantastic. Charlie, what can we wish you for the future? Is there any project that you want to talk about and think that we could maybe help you with following you?
I think some projects I would love to work with people like Cher or Grace Jones for sure.
Mm-hmm.
But then I think what I love to do is have my own island and then create my own world or my own cabaret or something.
Like David Copperfield.
Maybe.
I wish you that. Thank you so much for coming here today.
Thank you.
And we will be following your work. I'm Charlie Lemindou, and we'll be coming at your show in January for the Haute Coiffure in Paris, Rue Champs-Élysées. Avenue Champs-Élysées.
Rue François 1er.
Rue François 1er. Be there or be squared.
Thank you.
Thank you, Charlie.
Thank you.
It was Open the Gate. I see you next week. Same day, same time, 9 o'clock p.m. Be safe.